Today on Natural Gallant Bodybuilding News, man gets results without using full range of motion. Impossible? I think not. News at 11 for more info.
Train the muscles, not the joints.
Welcome back to Natural Gallant Bodybuilding, and today I'm going to talk to you a little bit about systemic stimulus, or stimulating your system. And this is spurred from a conversation. That's a lot of S's. This is spurred from a conversation I have with a guy in the gym. And I was just basically explaining to him, because he does pretty much parallel to deeper squats, right? That's the way he trains. And he's a guy that squats to parallel or deeper or whatever, because that's what he finds works for him. And that's what works with his body type, along with the sport that he wants to compete in, which is powerlifting. So the bottom line is that he is squatting accordingly. And I was joking around with him and I said, hey, if you want to learn how to squat wrong, do what I'm doing. And I just became conscious of the fact that why I do what I do has to do with stimulating my overall system. So sometimes just putting weight on your back or weight on your body will stimulate the entire system. And I said system a lot so far, so sorry about that. So when you stimulate your body in a holistic sort of way, you turn on all sorts of signal markers that tell the body that it needs to get stronger. So as long as you're not injuring it, you're basically helping coax it into growth. So I find it's the funniest thing. Like when I put four plates on my back, regardless of whether I'm doing deep squats or deep for me or a little bit shallower, as long as I'm challenging the muscles in whatever range of motion I'm doing, I notice that the body feels different that night and the next day. There's an overall body stimulation that goes on that feels quite pleasant and quite anabolic. I mean, my muscles start to get more swollen. I start to feel more pumpy and lumpy and all that sort of thing. And don't worry, if you can't squat because you've got a lower back problem, it doesn't necessarily have to be the squat. But I've noticed if you stimulate the entire body, there is something very relevant about that for natural bodybuilders. Now, another reason why I'm talking about this is that somebody on Instagram was saying something, you know, kind of ignorant. And the reason why I say it's kind of ignorant, and again, I'm gonna have to explain myself again here. Sometimes when I correct people on the internet, people say, hey, Jason, you come across as very condescending and this and that, and you know, you should watch how condescending you come across because it might turn some viewers off. I'm not trying to be condescending. What I'm trying to be is, let's just say I don't have much patience for people who are trying to perpetuate their ignorance upon others. Basically saying to you that you need to train a certain way because that's what worked for them, and that means if it worked for them, that's the only way to train. I don't have a lot of, let's just say, tolerance for people trying to enslave you, okay? So if that doesn't come across properly in my videos, sorry about that, but that's really my intent, is to basically break you free from some of the constraints of the dogma that are in the community, right? And like I said, most of the advanced people I've talked to agree with what I'm saying, because there's a certain amount of humility that is created from training, breaking yourself, sometimes getting results, sometimes not, and then seeing other people get results from using different techniques than you did, and you're like, oh, wait a second, maybe I don't know everything about everybody's body, maybe there's some other factors at work. So what I'm going to say here is that there was an Instagram post where somebody said partial ranges of motion don't work. And obviously they're saying that because they are finding something to be true for themselves as far as full range when it comes down to certain exercises and so forth. But to say that partial ranges don't work is not scientific at all. Because when you move a joint, regardless of whether it's through the full range of motion or a part range of motion, you are still using muscles to do this. And if the muscles are challenged, they will grow and they will adapt. It's kind of like somebody walking hills. If somebody walks hills and they put a tremendous amount of weight on their back, say you put 300 or 400 pounds on their back and they have to walk hills, you're saying that none of the muscles in their body are gonna grow just because it's not full range of motion, because their knees aren't, say, bending at 90 degrees or parallel, or like they're not squatting ass to the ground, so they won't get results. We know that that's crazy. I mean, from walking the hill, their calves are gonna get massive, massive results. Their butt's gonna get massive results, probably their hamstrings, and their quads, especially the lateralis, will get some work. So partial ranges do work. I mean, if you look at any person that does a power sport and they work through a part of the range of motion, but they challenge themselves explosively through that range of motion, they always have muscular development in that area. So really the way you should look at this is, am I challenging the body or not? And am I challenging the muscle as opposed to just making something really awkward? Or am I just challenging the stretch for the sake of stretch itself? These are different paradigms. These are different games to play. But the game of bodybuilding is, how do I challenge the muscle the most? And how do I continue to be able to do that day in and day out? And that is what's going to give you the most results. It's not about what is just harder because of lots of different reasons. Like, I'm juggling four balls at the same time and then doing squats on one leg. And if one of the balls drops, then somehow I failed at the exercise. I didn't do full range of juggling motion, right? So just because something's harder in a certain way doesn't mean that it's going to stimulate the muscle more effectively or get you more results. And that's really what you guys are after, saying, how do I get more results? How do I get less injuries? How do I find what is the perfect relationship with my body, right? So I encourage you to work with different ranges of motion and find out what that is. Because again, full range of motion is the other thing. Full range of motion is relative. I always talk about this, but it's like I have to repeat it because it seems like it's a lost concept. Because people come on my channel, they say, hell yeah, I'm doing partial ranges just like you do or whatever. It's like, I don't do partial ranges. I do full ranges for myself. I do full active ranges of motion for what is right for my body type. And that may be different for you. So active range of motion is the point to where you can keep tension on the muscle all the way through the stretch without it transferring just to you just relaxing on the joint. And passive range is the range of motion, which is the one that you could do like when you're laying around like a rag doll. You know what I'm saying? Like, say you could do the splits. Obviously you're not gonna put 500 pounds on your back when you're doing the splits. You know what I'm saying? Because that's a passive range of motion and you're not able to protect the joint at the same time during that range of motion. So active range of motion will be different for me than you, but you must find out what that ideal circumstance is in order for you to get the most amount of muscle mass and the least amount of injuries or problems. Because I get a long list of people commenting all the time, say, hey, I got an elbow pain, I got a shoulder pain, I got a knee pain, I got a problem, why is that? And a lot of times when I ask these people what they're doing, they're usually doing a range of motion in a way that is awkward for them or that is causing the stress to transfer more to the joint than the muscle. And like I said before, the joints are already taking a beating. Why are you basically making it even worse for them? So yeah, find out what that range of motion is and don't be afraid to experiment with partials and to stimulate the entire body, because stimulate the entire body and putting weight on the entire body is something that all the masters of powerlifting and bodybuilding have been doing since the dawn of time, because they knew that there was some results to be had there. So yeah, sometimes if I squat and I feel like, oh, my knees are tight, I don't want to go down as far, but I still put the weight on my back, I find that I get a great overall body pump from this. So then when I train the other body parts, I get more results and I feel more pumpy and lumpy. You know what I'm saying? Mountain. So yeah, sorry, I'm wearing a jacket. I know it doesn't show off the physique very good, but you know what? It's cold outside, man. The wind is cold. It's like, yeah. So yeah. Anyway, I hope this helps you out in your training. Thanks a lot for watching. If you need to get a hold of me, just go to naturalglandbodybuilding.com, and thanks to the Patreon supporters, and take care for now. Thanks for tuning in.
So here's my post-workout meal. Before my workout, 10 tablets of the Super Amino 23, and then I had 10 tablets of the Super Amino 23 after the workout. Then when I got home, I had a protein shake with greens, or troll guts, whatever you want to call it. And then about a half hour after that, I'm having some tiny bit of low sugar jam, rice, and turkey. So yeah, that's an example of what I'm doing, man. Mountain.